Good morning, folks. Shirley C. This is my recipe for prune and parsnip pies. It's how to turn this. Just taking one out of the freezer into this. Special request for somebody who wanted the recipe and didn't think I was real. Well, let me tell you, prune and parsnip pies are great. My husband decided he was going to make some parsnip wine over the weekend. So the byproduct was I had enough parsnips left over to make 60 prune and parsnip or prune and raisin or prune and cranberry pies. So here's a wee tune I'm making up as I go along. The key is C. Prune and parsnip pies, prune and parsnip pies. Cook them until tender, they will make a sweet surprise. Mash them with some cinnamon, add raw sugar and you're done. The tastiest thing to greet your loved one's eyes and his mouth. Gotta keep them happy, you know. Add the filling to some pastry, short crust or flaky fine. Place them in pie dishes or a pie maker. Bake at 170 degrees for half an hour or so. Your mate will think you are a clever baker because you are. Prune and parsnip pies, prune and parsnip pies. Cook them until tender, they will make a sweet surprise. Mash them with some cinnamon, add raw sugar, and you're done. The tastiest thing to greet your loved one's eyes, apart from your beautiful self, of course. Serve them hot or cold with custard or ice cream or yogurt if you want a different flavour. Add nutmeg on the top, adds to the taste. They are the best pies that your mouth will savour. Prune and parsnip pies, prune and parsnip pies. Most wonderful thing to greet loved ones' eyes. Mash them with some cinnamon and squeeze lemon juice if you like. Or sugar and you're done. The tastiest thing to greet your loved ones' eyes. Have a wonderful Shirley day. Now, I have to click on this.